In this video, I'll show you how I'm making some creepy or horror scenes for my new game, House of Chavez. Just a heads up, I don't have much experience with horror games, and I admit that horror games are better with 3D animations and stuff like that. But that's outside the reach of most indie developers. Psychological horror has always been my preference over blood and guts. For this scene, I have created a shadow that will move behind the window of the living room. Do you see it? It's hardly noticeable, but that's intentional. I hope the player will catch a glimpse of it after some time of looking at the screen, and the aim is to make them feel watched, as if something or someone is lurking outside. This effect in Ren'Py is pretty easy. I have a dog shape that I named Shadow, and I have this transform to make it move randomly behind the window. To put it behind it, I just used a mask called Living Room No Fire Window Mask. I'll show you how it works. Here you go, look. Hang on, I'm going to open it in Photoshop so it's more visible. Can you see now the part that's outside is completely transparent? This way we get this effect that the shadow is moving outside, behind the window. We have the outside scene, the shadow, the window mask, and finally the normal scene. In this scene, if you stay too much in the dark wood, first a warning will appear. It's pretty simple, just zooming in the background and adding a breathing sound. Then, if you insist in staying there, a death scene will trigger. I show a dark, menacing creature with red eyes and head appropriate sound effects. It looks like the creature is biting you. In this other scene, you can look outside the window and spot someone in distance. Even in this case, adding an appropriate sound effect is very important. As you see, are all scenes which should make the player feel uneasy, watched, like if something is not right, without being outright horror. This scene is a classic of horror movies. Adriana is getting ready for a date and light goes off. She turns her phone on to see in the dark, and for an instant she sees her face changing. I used an interesting glitch effect posted in Lemmasoft forums to have the face turn into a skull. It's very easy to set up. Last but not least, there's this scene in an abandoned building. I needed an old neon sound, perfectly synced with a blinking effect, simply done by flickering the whole screen black. I have a repeating timer so that the neon will flicker regularly, and also a water drop sound. In this scene, I also have a variable, Adriana's fear, displayed on top of the screen. As she discovers disturbing clues about this place, the fear value will go up. However, it will gradually decrease over time. In this case, the player must find the clue, but without rushing it too much to avoid getting too scared. Now I'm going full screen. To show the final result, you can hear the neon, the water drop, and when Adriana examines those pipes, a scary sound effect plays. But I have already spoiled too much of the game, so I'm going to stop here. I believe that the key to adding some horror elements in a visual novel, if you don't have a big budget, is to rely not just on visuals, like the images I showed you in the video, but also on well-written text and scary sound effects. Sound effects in particular can play a much more important role than you might think. That's it for now. I hope the video was helpful, even if just for picking up some Ren'Py programming tricks.